in ancient times, the Indian peoples who lived on the Great Plains were always moving from place to place, following the herds of buffalo. They trained their fastest horses to hunt buffalo. Mother carried water and collect firewood, she would run off to be with the horses. She stayed with them in the meadows, but was careful never to go beyond the sight of home. One hot day, when the sun was overhead, she felt sleepy. She spread her blanket and lay down. angry clouds began to roll out across the sky with lightning flashes in the darkness beneath.
Thank you.
she knew they were lost. Next morning, she was wakened by a loud neigh. A beautiful spotted stallion was prancing to and fro in front of her, stamping his hooves and shaking his mane. He was strong and proud and more handsome than any horse she had ever dreamed of. He told her that he was the leader of all the wild horses who roamed the hills. He welcomed her to live with them. She was glad. All her horses lifted their heads and neighed joyfully, happy to be free with the wild horses. People searched everywhere for the girl and the vanished horses. They were nowhere to be found. But a year later, two hunters rode into the hills where the wild horses lived. When they climbed the hill and looked over the top, they saw wild horses led by a beautiful spotted stallion. Beside him rode the girl, leading a colt. They called out to her. She waved back, but the stallion quickly drove her away with all his horses. The hunters galloped home and told what they had seen. The men mounted their fastest horses and set out at once. It was a long chase. The stallion defended the girl and the colt. He circled round and round them so the riders could not get near. They tried to catch him with ropes, but he dodged them. He had no fear. His eyes shone like cold stars. He snorted, and his hooves struck as fast as lightning. people would hear the stallion neighing sadly from the hilltop above the village, calling for her to come back. Days passed. Her parents knew the girl was lonely. She became ill, and the doctors could do nothing to help her. They asked what would make her well again. "I love to run with the wild horses," she answered. "They are my relatives. If you let me go back to them, I shall be happy forevermore." Her parents loved her and agreed that she should go back and live with the wild horses. They gave her a beautiful dress and the best horse in the village to ride. The spotted stallion led his wild horses down from the hills. The people gave them fine things to wear, colorful blankets and decorated saddles. They painted designs on their bodies and tied eagle feathers and ribbons in their manes and tails. The girl gave the colt to her parents. Everyone was joyful. Once again, the girl rode beside the spotted stallion. They were proud and happy together. Each year, she would come back, and she always brought her parents a colt. And then, one year, she did not return, and was never seen again. But when hunters next saw the wild horses, there galloped beside the mighty stallion a beautiful mare with a mane and tail floating like wispy clouds about her. The girl surely had become one of the wild horses at last. Today, we are still glad to remember that we have relatives among the horse people. It gives us joy to see the wild horses running free. Our thoughts fly with them.